Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we are reviewing a very big Japanese pen. This is a kind of pens that were made in Japan, especially in the first half of the 20th century. I can't really know when this pen was made, but it is part of a family of very big pens, which were called simply jumbo pens. These pens are usually like this. Some are have these cigar shape, others are flat tops. Usually the color is black. There are some red, orange, or some other colors. They usually are made of ebonite. It's the case of this one. And let's see some details about it. So, first of all, on the outside, what has this pen to show? I would say almost nothing. It's a very, very simple design. There is nothing on the top of the cap, nothing of the on the bottom. A very simple barrel, a very simple cap. The cap has a golden ring. That's it. There are some without the gold ring, and it has a clip that says there special, just that. The clip is quite good, but I don't know where you would clip such a big pen to. I'm saying this is a big pen, but before we go to the inside, let's just see how big this pen is. You may think this is maybe this is not that big, but you can see in the hand. I will show it with some other pens. So, here we have a Caveco Lilliput. This is a really small pen, but we can use a bigger pen, and this is a Parker Centennial Do Fold. And the Parker Centennial Do Fold is, I believe, a big size pen. But if we want, we can also compare it with a Vingsung 590, which is a very big pen. And as you can see, the Vingsung is a little longer, but it can't beat it in thickness. And just to show another one, this is an Indian one, a Varuna Gajendra pen, which is even longer, but not as thick as this one. So the jumbo pen really is a jumbo pen. Let me put the other pens aside. And let's continue. What more about this pen? So, we have here a cap that fits by screwing and unscrewing. You can take the cap off, and you have a nice section that tapers down, and then it flares. Flares out again and gives you a very nice rest for your fingers. But it is very big. It is hard to put all your fingers around. You can put, but the fingers don't touch each other, which is strange because we are used to much smaller pens. The nib is not as big as the rest of the pen, but it is a big nib. And here you have the Dufold nib. It is a little larger, wider, not longer, but it is a quite decent nib. It looks small because the pen is really big. More about it. The threads are very narrow and very on top of each other, so you don't feel it too much if you hold it higher, but you don't usually you hold it higher because the pen is too big. I have I would prefer to hold the pen next to the nib. The pen, although being very wide, you can hold it comfortably if you can get used to the very, very big size. And the pen even posts nicely but it is too top heavy and too big, which is quite fun to have a pen like this, but it's really, really heavy and big. Although the pen like this is not that heavy because it's made of ebonite and it's not a heavy pen. About the filling system. The filling system, this fills it is an eyedropper, so you have to unscrew the section and fill the pen, and it takes a large amount of ink, much more than 5 milliliters of ink, but I'll have to make ink capacity video for this pen to show you how much ink. Then you have here, there is a screw here. It's very big and very hard. You have to grab it with all your hand. You have this screw, and this allows you to have the pen has inside. Let's put it this way. When you see these pens at a flea market or something like that, that is where I bought this one. The vendor, if he doesn't understand anything about fountain pens, he will say this is like a piston filler because you can unscrew this. I won't do it because I don't want to create a big mess with ink, but you can unscrew this all and pull it out of the pen. And it leaves a big black rod here, and it stops somewhere around this. So if you have a very big piston inside, and people say, "Ah, this is a piston filler," and you can have and you can fill the pen. But this piston filler, it's not a piston. This is not to fill the pen. It has some kind of piston, yes, but that you use to when you screw the pen. Sorry, this has some. I've been washing and the pen is wet, and I think the piston may have the seal may have some leak inside. I didn't do anything to put the pen working well. This piston, this kind of piston, is like a valve that when you push it all. It touches the end of the feed on this side and keeps the ink from going out. So you can write with this if the feed is saturated, but then the ink will not get out. It is useful when you use eyedroppers to avoid the ink to blob out of the nib, which is something that sometimes happens with these kind of eyedroppers. When they are half empty or something like that. So let's now see how this pen writes. So here we have our usual. I'll open this just a little. Here we have our usual. Sorry, this is really leaking ink. From that side, that's what happens when you wash a pen and don't really put all the silicone grease that you need. This pen, the paper is the usual Rodia dot pad. The ink is the Parker Quink washable glue, and the pen is a special jumbo fountain pen. As you can see, I have have ink all over the place. This has to be fixed, the piston, the seal out there. This pen is a really big pen. It writes very smoothly, this nib. It has some feedback like usually Japanese pens have, but is quite smooth, and you can even have some kind of line variation. With this kind of pen, you surely and right forever because it has a very large amount of ink. So this pen to get really used well, it would need to have some silicone grease around this kind of valve, around this to avoid leaks, but I couldn't wait to make this video, so I didn't fix anything. But however, it is a very nice pen. With a little care, it will be writing very, very smoothly. You just have to put some silicone grease on the places it needs to just to avoid this kind of leakage. So, thank you so much for joining our channel, to watching our videos, and please subscribe our YouTube channel to see more of these videos about these pens, and hopefully with pens with a little less ink than today. See you next time. Bye.